Anyone in there? What's wrong with you?
You
ready?
Yeah.
I got a text.
Message!
Message!
That plant looks so sad.
You're the boss of it.
Excuse me. That's not going in.
I'm the one who edits it.
It's not going in. If you know, it's good for you. Alright, okay. Shake it up! Okay, let's go. Let's do this thing. Okay, so if you've been following us for a while, you'll know that we've started doing this top things to do in certain countries. Last time we did Italy, and then today we're gonna do Greece. So let's get started. Okay, so number one is the ruins in Athens. Athens is kind of known for its historic background and just history in general, I suppose. We're not big history buffs, but to go and see the ruins, like the Acropolis and the Parthenon, is that what it's called?
I think so.
I think it's called the Parthenon. It's definitely a must-do in Greece. A good thing to know about the ruins or any of the sites in Athens, if you're from the EU and you're under 21, it's actually free.
Not under 25.
Under 25?
I shall check.
I love being under 25.
Under 25.
It's pretty free. Much go for free. Every main attraction here in Greece.
Yeah. Oh, perfect. Thank you so much.
I love being under 25.
It's actually free admission into the majority of the sites, which is really good because if you're on a budget and you're traveling, you need to save money where you can.
So make sure to bring at least one form of ID. So number two is Zakynthos. Zakynthos, also known as Zante, is famous for... It's partying, but also it's beautiful beaches and clear water. One of the most popular things to see there is the shipwreck up on the northwest side of the island. You may hear the locals refer to the shipwreck as Smuggler's Cove.
It's located on a beach called Navagio Beach. Not too sure how you get there, but I'm sure if you ask anyone, it's well known around.
It's very popular.
Yeah.
Feeling good.
Water sports. Good.
Oh yeah, I want to do the banana thing.
So number three is water sports or like water activities in general. But no matter what island you're on, there's more than likely going to be a million different water activities you can take part in. The main island that's known for its water activities or water sports is Naxos, and that's just because it's a little bit different to the rest. All the rest of the islands like Santorini, Kos, all of those ones have just your classic tourist water activities like jet ski, paddleboard.
The banana one.
Banana.
I want to
see everywhere. So go take part if you're interested in that. Number four is unique accommodations. We actually have a playlist on unique accommodations that we've stayed in so far. We'll leave the link below. If I wanted to say that. Oh my gosh. In general, the unique accommodations that are like specific to Greece would be your cave pools, your...
They're so good.
Yeah. Oh, infinity pools.
The classic white cave.
Yeah. If you're looking for a hotel, look for your cave pool, your cave hotel, an infinity pool, and have it looking out on the caldera, which is basically looking out at the sea.
And make sure to get up for sunrise because it's just insane.
Having a hotel that is super unique and has an amazing view is definitely worthwhile and definitely worth spending a little bit of extra cash for that experience. Yes.
Number five is the narrow streets. On every island in Greece, you'll notice that the streets are just so narrow and they're just so picturesque. You have just the white and the blue colors mixing together and it just looks amazing. Between the street vendors and the small restaurants, you'll definitely find a great place to get a nice photo. Coming in. Number six is Greek food. We wouldn't put ourselves down as foodies, but...
Oh, I just hate that term. Foodies.
Food people.
First we started recording, and then we didn't even get to go on our trip because we had so long to record. What? Right, come on.
For a country that's just totally made up of islands, we really expected the food to be pretty much just fish-based for the whole thing, but yeah. There's so much variety.
So much good food.
It's so good. We didn't expect it to be as good as it was. But that's one thing that would definitely make us visit Greece again.
In our last things to do, we recommended that you do a food tour. So whether you do it with an agent or you just do it by yourselves, that's what we do. It's a really good way to go and get yourself out to like try the food if you're not exactly adventurous.
Get yourself immersed in the culture of the country.
Number seven is my favorite, which is Santorini.
Our favorite.
Okay, our favorite. It's probably the most famous, I would say.
Definitely the most famous.
Of Greece. So if you've seen photos of Greece, which I'm sure they have popped up on your feed one way or another, yeah. One thing that we noticed about Santorini is that the sunsets and sunrises were
insane.
They were insane. Like, I didn't get to see a sunrise because I enjoy my sleep. So if you haven't seen a sunrise, and he had said,
it's worth getting up. Just make sure you get up for at least one sunrise when you're there, because it's just, it will be your highlight of your trip.
Yeah. So there is a lot to do in Santorini, but we would recommend just going with the goal to basically just relax. A load of sunset bars, a load of like quaint restaurants. There's a lot to do there, but go relax and see a sunset and sunrise.
It's just one of those places you gotta go see.
Yeah.
Ooh, tell me how you feel, what you're gonna do. I see you on the beach down in Mexico. I wanna go to Mexico. Okay, so number 8 is Meteora. Unfortunately, this was one of the places that we really wanted to visit, but because we ended up getting locked down when we were in Greece, we didn't get a chance to go there. Meteora is this area 4 hours north from Athens, with these huge, huge rocks that look exactly like pillars. On top of the rocks, you'll find like these monasteries, and they just look absolutely insane. The fact that they were able to build monasteries on top of these huge rocks,
it's so weird. Like, what?
It doesn't make any sense. How were they able to do it? And because there are so many of these monasteries on top of the rocks, it happens to be the second largest
monastic community.
We think it's monastic community in Greece.
So next time we get to visit Greece, we're definitely going to put that on our bucket list and get it ticked off.
Number 9 is Messalani Cave.
No, Melissani. Not Messalani. Mel.
Melissani. So. So number 9 is Melissani Cave.
Take 4. Melissani Cave is located on the island of Kefalonia. In Greece, it's known as the Cave of Nymphs. I'm not sure why, but there you go. What it is. Basically, lake covered with a cave with a forest on the outside, and then it's like a big hole that lets in light, which makes the water appear really, really clear. And then with the light coming through, it makes it look like the boats are like floating on the water because it
looks so cool.
Yeah, the water is so clear. So like number 8, we didn't get to go to this cave either, just because we got locked down. But again, we will go
next time for sure. And lastly, number 10 is Tiny Planes. Now, this is a strange one, but most people would usually get the ferries between the islands, but we recommend you should get the planes. One, because most of the time, it's actually the same price, if not cheaper.
Yeah.
And it's more efficient to get you there quicker. The views from the plane are just incredible. If you go on a clear day, you're able to see all the islands underneath you. And if you end up going like us at sunset or sunrise,
oh,
you'll see the most amazing sunrise.
Yeah.
And that's it. We're currently in the middle of planning our next trip.
It's not going very well.
But our next video, you'll see us going to a new place, hopefully.
Hopefully being the key word. If you have anything else to add to the list, or if you've been to Greece and you had one thing that you really, really liked doing, add it in the comments below and we can get a conversation going. So cross your fingers and we will see you then.
Bye-bye. Bye.
Yeah. Oh, thank God. Okay, I need coffee and food. Coffee and food. Let's get the shoes in. Thank you, Santa. Thank you, Santa. Bye.